Welcome to the course Co-creating Sustainable Cities. In this video, I will introduce you to the key topics and concepts for this course on co-creation of sustainable cities. But first, have you ever imagined what cities might look like in the future when they are sustainable cities? Let's have a look. We see renewable energies that replaced fossil-based energy systems. Healthier ways of cooking in peri-urban slums. Circular systems for water and waste. Cyclists and infrastructures for slow mobility. Green spaces that allow for recreation, but also cool down the city when temperature rises. Largely, this is a picture of the future. Today, city authorities and scholars work collaboratively to prevent flooding, to combat heavy air pollution, and to give citizens access to safe food, sanitation, and drinking water. To become sustainable, cities need transitions in what we call their urban fabric. The urban fabric stands for the materials, technologies, infrastructures, together with the human activity, that make the city into what it is, a complex functional system that is home to its citizens. For urban sustainability transitions to occur, technological and social innovations are equally important. Innovative solutions will only be effective when they are endorsed by citizens and when they fit their lifestyles and their everyday life routines. People therefore do matter for sustainability transitions in cities in many ways. Citizens matter, for example, when they adopt innovations and give them a place in their everyday life, as in the case of electric cars, or when a new toilet-based sanitation system is introduced. People also matter when acting as innovators themselves, for example, when they organize weekly cycling events to put pressure on local authorities for more bike paths in the cities. Moreover, people matter as co-producers of products and services. And this is the case when householders put PV panels on their roofs to produce renewable energy. On another occasion, people matter when they start a local food bank that gives low-income people access to safe, healthy, and more sustainable food. These are just a few examples of when and how people matter and contribute to sustainability transitions. In the course, you will work with many more forms of co-creation as enacted by citizens in cities around the world. We refer to citizens as co-creators because they never operate alone. They work together with other stakeholders, for example, companies, NGOs, municipal authorities, water boards, energy providers, software developers, urban planners, farmers, schoolers, and so on. In the course, we will together with you explore these relations between citizens and the different stakeholders. We discuss with you why some relations are successful and others fail, why sometimes collaboration is going smooth, and in other instances, disagreements and conflicts frequently happen. When finishing this course, you will be an expert on co-creation. This means first that you are familiar with the two fundamental dimensions of co-creation, the co-creation of city politics and the co-creation of social technical systems for energy, water and food. Secondly, after this course you will have a deep and broad understanding of co-creation. This is because you will get to know and discuss with us the ins and outs of many concrete empirical examples of co-creation around the world. Finally, after the course, you will be able to indicate which forms of co-creation are valid and invalid for specific cases, cities and situations. As you see, the course has a global outlook. On our journey, we will visit three regions of the world. You will get to know about co-creation in Asia, Africa and Europe when we visit the cities of Beijing, Hanoi, Kampala, and Amsterdam. Besides the global outlook, the course also has an inter- and transdisciplinary setup. Interdisciplinary means that you will see both technical scientists and social scientists at work, talking about their research. Transdisciplinary means that you will meet not only scientists, but also people in society, like mayors, CEOs of companies, activists, and members of NGOs, and of course, many different groups of citizens. At the end of this video, I hope you see that co-creating sustainable cities is a rich and diverse topic that we are pleased to explore with you. Citizens and other stakeholders are contributing to city politics and to transitions in social technical systems that support their daily life. We are happy that you are joining us and hope you will find the course challenging, interesting, food for thought, and also fun.